Hi everyone, welcome to SAISER classes. Today in this video we have to first draw a rhombus of each side 6 cm and one angle 60 degree. Then we have to draw a right angle triangle of equal area. So let's start the video. So now first of all, leaving here some space to write down all the steps, so steps of construction and its proof. So leaving here some space by this way. So now first we have to draw a line segment of length 6 cm. So starting 0 and this is 6. So first drawing here a line segment and taking point here A and here B. So AB equals to 6 cm. So first step, draw a line segment AB of length 6 cm first. Now we have to draw a 60 degree angle on the point A. So putting the compass and taking any length and drawing an arc by this way, and putting the compass here, taking same length and cut here. Now first joining this line to get here a 60 degree angle. So we got a 60 degree angle. So in number two step, we have to draw a 60 degree angle by using compass or protractor. Okay, now taking the length AB equals to 6 cm by using compass by this way and cut here. So taking here a point D, so AD equals to 6 cm. So step number 3, taking 6 cm by using compass and cut the line at a point D, so AD equals to 6 cm. Again taking the length 6 cm and putting the compass on the point D and drawing an arc by this way, and putting the compass on the point B and cut here. So both the arc intersect here at a point C. So first joining B and C, then joining C and D. Okay, and obviously this is will be 6 cm and this will be 6 cm. So step number 4, again taking 6 cm length by using compass and putting the compass on the point B and D and drawing two arc which meet at a point C. So taking point C and first join B and C and join C and D. So first we get our required rhombus ABCD. So by this way you have to first construct the rhombus ABCD. Okay, next here first taking the length AB equals to 6 cm and putting the compass on the point B and cut here. So here I am going to extend the line AB by this way up to E point. So B equals to 6 cm obviously, and joining D and E. So step number 5, extending the line AB. So first extend the line AB up to E point. So obviously B equals to 6 cm and total length AE equals to 6 plus 6, so total 12 cm. So here and joining D and E. So by joining DE, so we get our required right angle triangle ADE. So by this way, you can first construct a right angle triangle ADE. Okay. Now I'm going to prove this. So here, now I'm going to prove all this. So first we have to join B and D, then joining A and C, and these are the two diagonal of the rhombus ABCD. Okay, so here first join BD and join the diagonal A and C. Okay, so now here the length AB and AD are equal. So this line and this line are equal, and we also know that this angle and this angle must be equal. So two equal side and their corresponding angles will be equal and 60 degree, because one angle is already 60 degree. So from triangle ABD, this is obviously 6 centimeter. Okay, so first of all, here since the side here, the side AB, so AB equals to AD, so we can say that the corresponding angle, first angle ADB and angle ABD equals to 60 degree. Okay, so the side BD obviously 6 centimeter, because it forms an equilateral triangle. So BD is a diagonal of the rhombus ABCD. Okay, so from this we can say that the triangle ABD, so triangle ABD is an equilateral triangle. So here first I have proved triangle ABD is a right angle triangle. Okay, next, now here the side BE and BD are equal, this side and this side are equal, so here BE equals to BD. Then we can write, so this angle and this corresponding angle must be equal. So first here I am going to find the angle from this here, from this to this. So first finding this angle. Okay, and we know this is total 180 degree. This is total 180 degree. So angle DBE equals to total 180 degree and subtracting 60 degree. So then we can get the angle. This is 120 degree. So this is 120 degree angle. And then we can say that the angle BDE equals to angle BED equals, so this is obviously 30 degree. Okay, so this is 30 degree. Now this is 30 degree and this angle also 30 degree. Now this is total, so 60 plus 30, and so this is total 90 degree. So angle ADE equals to 60 degree plus 30 degree equals to 90 degree. So from this we can say that the triangle ADE, so triangle ADE is a right angle triangle. So here I have proved the triangle ABD is a right angle triangle. Next, finding the midpoint of the line AB. So this is total 6 centimeter length, so 3 will be the midpoint of the side. So taking point here F. Okay, so first joining D and F by this way. And we also know that the median of an equilateral triangle bisect the line AV into two equal part. So here the line DF divided the line AV into two equal part. So this length and this length are equal. Okay. So from this equilateral triangle, now finding the height, and we know that the formula of height equals to root 3 by 2 into side, and here the length of side equals to 6, so dividing by 2, so this is 3 root 3 centimeter. So height equals to 3 root 3 centimeter. Now here the equilateral triangle ABD, and this is also, so this also an equilateral triangle because the three sides are equal. So and the both diagonal intersect here at a point, so taking point here G. So from this rhombus, this diagonal and this diagonal intersect here and bisect each other equally. So we know that diagonals of a rhombus intersect each other equally. We know that. So this is an equilateral triangle, and this is also an equilateral triangle. So this is a perpendicular line, and this is also be a perpendicular line. So similarly, we can say that AZ, so this is also a height of the equilateral triangle. So AZ equals to similarly 3 root 3 centimeter. So the diagonal AC equals to, this is 3 root 3, and this is will be 3 root 3, and this will be 3 root 3. So the diagonal total 6 root 3 centimeter. Next, I'm going to find the area of the rhombus ABCD. So here first, finding the area of the rhombus ABCD. So area of a rhombus equals to the product of the diagonal divided by 2. Okay, so now putting the value of the diagonals, so this is 6 root 3 plus this is 6 by 2. Now dividing by 2, so this is 3, so this is 18 root 3 square centimeter. Next, finding the area of the right angle triangle ADE. So now I'm going to find the area of the right angle triangle ADE, and we know that the formula is half into height DF plus the base AE, and the value of the height equals to 3 root 3 into this is 12. Now dividing by 2, so this is 18 root 3 square centimeter. So here the area of the rhombus and area of the right angle triangle are equal. So that's all. Thanks for